Hi everyone. I am trying something new here. I was commissioned to paint a little gecko hanging from a paintbrush, similar to a sloth piece that I have. And my customer asked me if I could do a little crested gecko, which is what she has. So I'm using watercolors. And actually, watercolor markers also. I'll switch to those for some of the brighter colors that I have in there in that other watercolor pen. And she liked those colors. That's what she saw. So when you use watercolors, you can put the water down first. You can put the paint down first. I'm not sure what's right, wrong, whatever. I just do whatever feels right at that time for me. So you can see how it bleeds a little. It's only going to go wherever you put the water, which is nice. Put a little blue in here. Watercolors dry a little lighter. I'm really used to more acrylics, which acrylics dry darker, so I'm used to adjusting my colors as I paint. With watercolor, it's a little different, so they dry a little lighter. You can always go back in, add another layer. So this little guy is mostly tans, browns. I'm going to start with the lighter colors on him. I did sketch it lightly with a watercolor pencil. That way it the pencil marks will bleed right back into the art instead of staying visible. So there's his little tail, and he's a little darker under the belly. Let me get that in here. I'll go back in with some other darker tones, these little points, little jaggy. I don't know what they're called. I don't know anything about geckos. I know a little bit more about sloths, as you all know. So just getting this on here. With watercolor, you work light to dark. So this is very different for me, as I'm trained more so with acrylics, which is the opposite. But I'm learning. You always learn. I'm always learning. I still have so much to learn. And the only way to learn is to just do it. Try it. So this is a good time for everyone to just grab some watercolors or color pencils, markers, crayons, anything. Just get creative. It's very therapeutic. It's been stressful the last few days, and this has actually been the most relaxed I've been, I think, in the last few days. But you can see I put the water on first, and it blends really nicely too. So I'll go back in with the darker. This, I already have the paint on, and then I'll go back in with some other colors, different shades, just a little darker under here. Watercolor is great because you can only control it to a certain point, and that's what's nice about it. You just have to see how that just, those little spots just kind of bleed through, and that's kind of fun, and that gives me a little texture, that little scales or whatever they have on their bodies. Effortless. And as it dries, it will change a little, and you kind of really don't know what you're going to get until you see it finished. So you can control it a little bit, but then on the other hand, You can't, and that's what's nice about it. You just got to go for it. Just put your paintbrush down and just do it. This arm, I guess they're arms, right? Arms, legs. I think that would be a little bit darker. There we go. Get his little eye on there. So they have this ridge from their eye over. This looks a little like that. The one thing I do like about doing custom work, which I've been doing for 38 years, is most of the time I have to do some research to learn about a particular animal or a place in the world or a landscape, you know, with the murals. And so I learn a lot too. It's a lot of fun. So his eyes look like they're a little more kind of golden. I'm going to put a little bit more color in here, even though they may not be that colorful, but I'm going to do it anyway. Just to add a little life. So I'm going to let that dry a little and go in with these are mermaid markers. So they are watercolor pens, and the pigment is right inside the pen, and you can use it just like the other watercolors. You can put the water down first, you can put the pigment down, whichever way you choose. The nice thing is you can travel with these because you can just take your little case with your pens. So right here you could see I'm just going right in, and it's a little dry there, so I'm going to take my brush and just wet that and then let that bleed into the yellow. I do like to give the paints the opportunity to just do their thing, you know. The other fun thing that you can do with watercolors, if you have a lot of water or very wet, you can put kosher salt on the water, the very wet areas, and that'll wick some of the color up and give you some nice texture and interest too. So that one I put the water down first. So you just squeeze these a little bit to get more of the paint. I'm gonna squeeze that a little bit more. Okay, there we go. Get that out there. Move that around a little bit. And again, just gonna add a little more water. Oops, oopsie. Got some water drips up there. Okay, so add some blue. This, when you squeeze the paints out of these pens, it tends to come out pretty quickly. So I didn't want to squeeze it on there. So it might be easier just to do the water first. Just kind of move it around. And then the purple I already had out on my palette, which I'm using the bottom or the lid of an egg carton. It works really nicely. And there. Ooh, inky dark purple. So sorry. Just hit my camera. You can tell I'm not good at this, not good at filming here. But I'm trying. Get some little purple in here. Get some purple in here. Let me grab that red again. Get some red in here. Red, our eyes see red and red first, I believe, and then yellow. So if you want to draw attention to an area, definitely use red, also yellow. I was told by my nephews who are hockey players that the reason the yellow is on the hockey rinks, on the border of the hockey rinks is yellow so that they can see it easily enough. And also opponents have been known to put yellow laces on their skates to distract their opponents. Their eyes will go to the laces instead of the puck. Anyway, that's what I was told. Okay, so here's some little drips. I'm going to put a little bit more yellow in there. So this is looking, it's okay. I need to go back in now. This little guy did get a little bit, did dry up some. So I am going to, let's see. Let me get his little nose. The little nose. Darker around. You can see how you can always go darker. Once it's on there, that's it. So I'm going to put this darker tones here, and then I'm going to wet my brush again. And when you use watercolors, your water basin reservoir, try to keep it as clean as possible. I like to use glass, a glass jar or glass container, because when you shake your brush, you have a tendency to possibly move the water reservoir if it's too light, and it could knock over. So this little guy, yeah, he's looking all right. I need to blend this out a little bit. I think the most difficult part for me is to know when to stop, especially with the watercolors, because you can really overdo it very easily. And it's better to just wait, let it dry. You can always go back in. I do need to do his little pupil there. Hopefully that's not gonna... I think I'm gonna go back in a little bit of orange. Even though it's not really orange, I'm going to take creative license here and just, it needs jazzed up. Oh, geez. See what I just did? Oh, well. Okay. A little bit. Just need a little bit of color. So there is the crested gecko. Crested gecko hanging on the paintbrush for my customer. So I'm probably going to try this again with some other pieces. Maybe I'll do some larger pieces as well. I paint with acrylics and mixed media, all different types. So I might do a nice big piece. I do some live painting at the National Aviary usually each year for their night in the tropics. And I like to paint really big too. Paint murals, custom murals. I've been doing this all for about 38 years, but the watercolor, it's a little new for me. Kind of feel like that's a little dark in there and I feel like I overdid it. I'm gonna dab that. Yeah. Well, I'm gonna let this dry and then I'll come back to it. I see this little spot here. I'm just going to wet it, make that go away. So that looks pretty cute. Might need a couple little areas where it needs a little darker. So let it dry. I'll come back, check it out. So come back. Hopefully this inspires you, maybe, to try your own. Okay, a little gecko on a paintbrush. That's it.